Hi, my name is Keith Mazza. Most of you know me as Sifu Keith. Welcome to our channel.
Hello everybody, Sifu Keith here. In today's video, we're going to bring you the beginning of Chum Kiu applications on the wind dummy, how to train your Chum Kiu form on the wind dummy, and then how to apply it in combat situation. But before we do there, I need you to click the two boxes to like and subscribe, and hit the bell to always to be kept up with our latest videos. Thank you and have a great day.
So, Chum Kiu form on the wind dummy. Utilizing the dummy to work on your accuracy and your training. So just remember, we use the fingertip exercises when we're gonna strike with that. Make sure you pad the dummy. You have the lungs, large intestines, circular sacs, sanjiao, heart and small intestines. So you always wanna hit small things. So moving into the Chum Kiu form, starting from here, the double elbow like a jiutsu, and then a byuji strike here. So even though we're utilizing two hands, we'll only use one at a time for application. So training it on the dummy, starting in a front stance, moving outside with the lao sao, pak sao, byuji strike, lop sao, and a byuji strike. So again, coming through, moving outside with a pak sao, byuji strike high, a lop sao, and a byuji strike. So this would be emulating strikes to the neck. So one more time, coming through, pak sao byuji, lop sao byuji. So let's look at applications to that. So I'm gonna line up here just like we did in the wind dummy. So straight punch comes in, I'm stepping off the line here with a pak. On the dummy, I was lined up here. So sometimes you're lining up inside. So when he throws that punch, I'm gonna lao sao and slip to the outside. From here, a pak sao byuji to the neck, and a lop sao and a byuji to the neck. So again with that, coming through, pak sao byuji, lop sao byuji. Another application that we can do with that is we can deal with a straight and a round punch. Straight punch comes in, pak sao byuji, and he throws a round punch. So I'm gonna step off, I'm gonna release here with a lop, and again, byuji to the neck. Finally, again, pak sao byuji to the neck. So let's take it just from a different angle. Punch comes in, pak sao byuji, round punch comes in. I take the lop with a release step, I byuji, and then pak again, moving back to the outside, with a byuji strike to the neck. So you can work inside and outside with this. And again, it's just a double byuji from the Chum Kiu. So in this section, in the second part, we're gonna work our way into the elbow section, the triple bong sao section. So you can look at this. You can work inside or outside on this. So from here, I'm gonna start. I'm gonna bong sao outside, emulating my opponent throw a straight punch. Bong sao two and bong sao three. So because the dummy does not move, I have to move around the dummy. So again, from here, bong sao one, bong sao two, bong sao three. So here I'm gonna backstep, pak sao, train the front kick, coming through, arm break one, arm break two, arm break three, cover, three palm strikes, left, right, and left. So let's look at that again. Bong sao one, bong sao two, bong sao three. Shin pak, front kick, on break one, two, and three, cover, three palm strikes, left, right, and left. Okay, so let's look at some applications from this. So in the form, you train three bong saos, just to train the movement. It's very rare you're gonna deal with three consecutive punches with three consecutive bong saos. So let's just look at some various applications. So, first one, straight punch. I'm gonna come in and look, I'm stepping off the line, so I'm facing my opponent. Some people, they don't train this properly, they turn this way. Your opponent's in front of you, so you're off at a 45 degree angle, so I'm stepping off here. So like I did in the dummy, I'm gonna take a back step in the pak, and the pak is to create an opening here for my kick. So again, the bong sao, the step, the kick from here. Now, if Keith's elbow's down, I can take the break at this angle. And again, training three motions, but reality is only gonna be one break. If his arm was turned over like a more Western boxing pose, the arm break would come to the side. So let's demonstrate on this side. Bong sao, the pak sao clears, the front kick, so Keith's elbow's up, and I'm catching it here, utilizing this arm break. So your arm break will depend on the punch you're dealing with. So again, from here, bong sao, pak sao, front kick, the elbow's down, My arm, now I need to move it. So here's the clear, just clearing it out of the way, and then three palm strikes. One, two, and three. Opposite side. Bong sao, back step, pox out, front kick. Now, his arm's slightly canted off, so I'm gonna utilize this arm break. Cover and clear, one, two, and three. So, that's dealing with straight, so we might have a straight punch here and a round punch, because in the Chum Kiu form, from here we go boom, tiun to pak, and we step through for the kick. He's gonna throw a straight punch. Same thing, here's my release step. He's now gonna throw a round punch. So I'm gonna step across, getting away from that arm, and this opens up all my targets in here. Take the front kick. I'm gonna bridge a little closer so I can get to the arm break. We're gonna pox out punch. Here, take the arm break, clearing, and then one, two, and three. Look at it in another angle. Straight punch on this side, here's my release. Round punch is gonna come. I'm gonna step across and open this area up for my kick. Take my break off to the side, clear down, one, two, and three. So, again, you have to modify things because the dummy's not gonna move. So we finished the Chum Kiu section with the third palm strike. So you know the movements to step over for a chun and a lop. I do not have a lot of room in here, so the movement's gonna just be slight. So from here, I'm just gonna take a slight stutter step for the chun sao. So from here, chun sao. So I have to reset in here to get to that point. So when I finish with the three palm strikes, when I move in, I would reset from here. Stepping across, chun sao, bringing my hand on top of the lop sao, and the front kick. So I can move to the outside, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, and the last is a lop and a punch coming through the center. Another application for this here is, after the chin and the lop from here, is I can take the bong sao off the inside, bong sao, and then train it to the outside, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao, to punch. Based on your frame and your body structure, it might be a little tough working in the middle on this. Let's take it again one more time. From here, a little stutter step, chin sao, lop sao, front kick. Releasing, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao punch. The variation to it, chun sao, lop sao, front kick, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao, bong sao, lop sao, punch. So let's take an application through this. Very much self-explanatory from here. The round punch is gonna come, I'm gonna step over to intercept. Okay, with my chun sao, I'm gonna thread up to his arm, I'm gonna take this back step over, and I'm gonna apply a lop sao, and again, to open up these parameters in here. Now the round punch comes, my bong sao is here, my lop sao, and I punch over the top. So let's look at that again. Coming through, chun sao, lop sao, front kick, bong sao, lop sao, and punch. You can work this and combine two pieces, taking the bong sao with that. So you had your bong sao, we finished with the palm, and then the chun sao. So a drill I like to do is have your partner vary what's gonna happen. If he throws a straight punch, I take a release step bong sao, utilize the pak sao front kick. If he throws a round punch all parallel side, the chun sao lop sao with the front kick, and then follow yourself all the way through. So, you know, Wing Chun, we watch the elbows. If the elbow's down, it's gonna be a straight punch. If the elbow's cocked up, it's gonna be a round punch. So it's a really good exercise to start to determine and probability of how punches are gonna come dealing with straight and round punches. And again, we're just isolating off a parallel side.
And don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and share buttons. And when you hit the subscribe button, please hit the bell notification to all so we can let you know as soon as we put out a new video. And we want you to know that we're here for you. So leave your comments below. We're going to get back to each and every one of you to make sure your questions get answered.
And once again, thank you. We look forward to being your All Things Wing Chun and more for many years to come.